Earlier when we were configuring this sample My Note, we just discussed briefly some of the options here that I'd like to go back into in more detail. For example, one of the options in this comparison and in all, most of the other conditions except SQC, or comparison PE, they all support this time true option. And the time true is a fairly straightforward concept. What we're saying is that the notification has to be true for a certain amount of time. And so you specify this as, say, 10 minutes. And then that's something that has to exist. That condition that's defined by that set of criteria here, this condition has to exist for at least 10 minutes. Now, there are a couple of options here that really require explanation. Clock simply means that it's going to do what you anticipate it to do, which is we have a triggering condition, we'll wait 10 minutes, and then we'll send the notification. What could natural possibly mean? Well, natural, if you're familiar with what we mean when we refer to natural scheduling of things in Pi, in the Pi system, it generally means something that's based on some kind of snapshot value coming in, some new value coming in for a Pi tag. And that's what we're talking about here, too. We're going to make this natural scheduling or natural time true option based on the activity of new values coming in to be evaluated in the notification. It works something like this illustration that you see in your class materials. Imagine that we've got a sequence like you see right here, in which these values are coming in and they're not above the high limit yet. So this right here is the high limit. Until we go above that high limit, there's no notification condition that becomes true. Once we go over this, then we're going to start the countdown. We're starting the countdown defined by this time true. Now, when natural is selected, what we mean by that is after that time true is over, at this point in time right here, at that point, we're ready to send the notification, but we're not going to send it, in fact, until we evaluate a new snapshot value that is involved in this notification. So in other words, we wait for one more value to come in. And once that value comes in, then at that point we go ahead and trigger the condition or trigger the notification. So why would you want to use this? Well, we see this when you have something like a manual input that only gets updated very seldom, maybe once every 24 hours or something like that, or every 8 hours. And what you'd like to do is you'd like to have something that essentially waits until we get another value that's outside that, whatever criteria is used to define the notification. We want to wait for one more value before we go ahead and send that out. So, we have a condition like, for example, if we have this condition right here that goes outside, we're going to wait a period of time until we get another condition that's also outside above this high limit right here. And so for things that don't come in that often, that's a choice that you might be interested in to reduce the number of, I guess, what you would call a notification that's triggered on just some outlier that doesn't repeat itself.